Today is the 3rd of June, 2023. Okay, so for all of you who keep wondering, oh, why are we watching these old videos? Well, one of the advantages of being taken down so many times is before you re-put your videos up, you have to watch them to make sure you didn't say anything wrong. And that can be really, really painful. But I have just found so much amazing stuff on there that I really have to show you, because I know a lot of you are struggling, and you know, I want you to know that I have been there. I've had a most wonderful week and just so uplifted. The Lord's been speaking to me so many ways, but I know a lot of people are struggling. And for those of you who are there, I just want to, you know, just re-strengthen you, you know, tell you to go back to your first love and, you know, remember what it was like when you really put your trust in Christ. Now, so what should I tell you first? It's just so much. Okay, and some of you may know this guy here, Patriot Street Fighter. So he replied to me last week, and for those of you who don't know him, he's a great guy. He's got a lot of good friends.
Guys, I would love to continue this show. Unfortunately, our producer has to get another stream up and moving, but because we're going to be doing several episodes here, we're going to be able to pick up on this particular point, of course, and I think that's pulled out at some point.
They're talking about all the amazing things that are happening, you know, but one thing that did happen to him was that he was taken down off this this tour, I think it's in Miami, and Rachel Maddow did a, you know, a piece on the television, and Alan Dershowitz also absolutely, you know, pulled him out. So I'm not going to go there right now, but this is all together, you know, and there's just so many positive things happening. And as you know, the sound, that one there, it's like the white hat revelations. And what I found too with my own videos, these old ones that I'm putting up, they've got all these bad words that would have got me flagged before, but for some reason they're not getting me flagged anymore. And this guy who I talked to you about, who is, I'll just show you a little bit of it. He also, even though, so I've got an email from him today, and he was the big expert on the number 17th letter, and he is a professor, so that's his name there. Can you see it? Okay, and at first he thought he had been, he says here, sometimes we experience disappointments in life as we are being protected from an unseen risk, which we only appreciate later on. However, I got a huge surprise when a few hours later, a friend messages me to say my account had been restored. So I quickly sent out my first tweet. Okay, so that was 30 minutes ago. And what's he calling himself? Da-da. Still there. And here, can you see that? Okay, I'm going to be, what if? Okay. And that's where I believe we're at. And watching one of my videos, so I'll just take you to one of them now, which was showing, you know, just absolutely proving without a doubt that what I found and believed. So I'll just let you have a look through my thumbnails, because that, you know, this is the best way to see my Saint Germain. And if you, you know, Saint Germain, okay, so I will actually touch this with my, have I got my thingy? Okay, with my finger here. Okay, no, this is what happens. So with the two screens, it gets a bit thingy. So yeah, I've got to do it on this one here on the table, okay? So here you've got the cheekbone, you've got the eye here, with the pupil, the eye. You can't see the eyebrow, but there's a nose and the beard, okay? So that's my Saint Germain. Excuse me. And if you don't know, that's he's the one that's like the wandering Jew, you know, has been reported through all the centuries, and who is behind this whole Nasara Gazara. movement. So it's very appropriate that I should see that in March this year. So that is, I think, officially about the last sign I have seen. But, okay, how many of you guys know this guy? Okay, Don McLean, one of your best, if not your best. And he really brought to the fore a song this week that, and this is with this one, I really never liked.
A long, long time ago, I can still remember how that music used to make me smile.
Okay, do you know that one? You know, Bye Bye, Miss American Pie, drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Wow. But the song that, you know, really pulls it out for me with regards to him is Vincent, and that's why I called my restaurant Vincent, because I have always, here's my card, one of my cards, here's that I did for my cafe. It's the Yellow House. You know, that these songwriters, you know, speak. You know, I mean, did you know that Vincent van Gogh never sold a single painting in his life? But they are now worth, like, the latest one was $44 million. And unfortunately, that's how our world goes. And when you understand that it's all there to demoralise you, to break your heart, so that you don't reach that level, that you don't believe, as Jesus told us to believe, that greater things than these can we do if only we believe. And that's what I'm speaking of this week, because I haven't told you, but you know, my, you know, beginning life was very tragic, and I ended up, you know, long story short, you know, I ended up having a nervous breakdown when I was only 15, and I was under 16, and I was under a psychiatrist, you know, for quite a few years, totally drugged up beyond belief, and for most of my life, and it was only really that, you know, because they told me I wasn't ready to have children, that I did have children, and they ended up being my salvation, you know, but, you know, when I still carried on with, you know, on and off drugs, depression and that sort of thing, on and off, until I got born again. And when I got born again, that's it. I threw away everything. And, you know, and so I had to go and, you know, see the analysts, and they had to sort of confirm, yes, I was, that the conversion I'd had was real, and, you know, and that it was safe for me to be off my medication. So so that, and that's, you know, where I've been all these years. But recently I had my natal charts done, and a lot of you might think, oh my God, you know, how can you do that? And that's what I, you know, for those of you who know my story, I gave up. I was into astrology, I was into tarot cards, I was into numerology before I got born again. And my, you know, big story was burning them all and, you know, giving it all up. But I've actually now found that I didn't have to give up all that stuff. Although I believe I had to give it up then, because I had to learn what God told me, which is that I don't put my trust in anything but Him, right? And so He had to develop this relationship in me where I believed in Him, saw Him, you know, do the magic in my life and believe in it. And I really did, you know. And people, I used to go around saying to everyone, driving them crazy, saying, touch me, I'm gold, you know, because I believed it. Something had happened in my mind that, you know, made me believe that I could do anything. And while I believed that, I could. But of course, you know, then Satan comes and he just, you know, people talk about this fence that God puts around you, you know, but, you know, the world comes to try and drag you down, you know, the minute that they see that. And there's a reason for that. And I think I came across that reason today. Here it is, yeah. So this is Wham, and this is, you'll all know this, what's happening with this, the food shortages. And he nailed it for
this
me.
Notion of everyone, transhumanists, really, everyone, man and machine working together in lockstep, however,
with no individual decisions made, everything made by algorithms, made by computers, made by the state, in order to control people and walk them off the cliff. And when we see the move for mRNA-infused foods, for example, that is already happening in some cases. They've already found traces in meat at many grocery stores. They found, they've funded huge studies by algorithms made by robotic collectivist notion of everyone, transhumanists really, everyone, man and machine, working together in lockstep, however, with no end of...
So he's talking about...
how much gas, water, electricity.
You know, he just... He said in there, so walking you away from your soul. And I think that, you know, that is when he said that, I thought, of course, that's why they're doing it, and why, even though we know we are winning, there's just so many people who aren't winning, so many people who are going along with it. And because, you know, we are this collective mind, and that is what's really come to me this week. So I'll just show you a couple of the funny things that happened. So this is the first of June, this dream here. And it was, I was in a contemporary bank where I was being encouraged to get into logistics. If anyone knows me, they know logistics. I don't even know what it is, you know, but numbers and me just don't go together. As they knew, I would be very good at it. I was surprised. I was compared to Muldoon and shown red plastic rubber wrist bracelets. Now, I don't know if you know, they're like the hospital ones. You know, they've just got these narrow rubber wrist bracelets. And have you seen them on the stars? Well, that is, if you don't know, one of those, I won't use the word that I would normally yet. I will use child abuser if I have to, okay? So that is a sign, the club sign, is these reds, you know, this red string that they have around there. But in my dream, it was like a hospital, a bit wider, it was the red thingy. But on it were the words, written in white lettering, stand up, stand up. And I was seeing quite a few. It was being re-emphasised. And then I was choosing the best club sandwiches, okay, stand up. Then I saw, okay, that's probably not that important, but everything I would need to do something. Oh, it could be actually. Then I saw my hair parted and flat against my skull with the grey roots obvious, as if to point out that I would need to do something about my hairstyle to fit my elevation as a logistics expert in this bank. Okay, so the grey, you know, could represent wisdom, or but it was flat and I just needed to do a makeover for this new life. Well, the interesting thing is the word Muldoon. Now, for you Americans, you won't know who Muldoon is, but in New Zealand, everyone, you know, over the age of 30 knows Rob Muldoon. And there's no way I would have known this, and I'll just show you. He's a real good-looking guy. I'm just joking. But, yeah, they used to call him Piggy. There he is there. But it says here he was the first fully qualified cost accountant, serving as a corporal and sergeant in the army in Second World War. Muldoon completed his training as an accountant and returned to New Zealand as its first fully qualified cost accountant. He was first elected to the House of Representatives, so he ended up becoming our Prime Minister. And he had a wicked sense of humour. That's actually an injury, that thingy there. But, you know, and he had, and they actually, he became an actor on that, monster show. There was some sort of black Rocky Horror show. And he was actually on that too, you know, just for a bit of a laugh. So, you know, when I saw that, I thought, well, there's just no way in this world I'm going to be dreaming of a man who's been dead for 30-odd years, you know, the Lord speaking to me. So, of course, here it was, the logistics, and I had to think, what does it mean? Is it? And it's like, yeah, God's telling me I've got all the logistics. I've got, you know, all the facts. And this is what comes out to me all the time when I find come across these old videos of mine, which I absolutely forget about. So you guys who ask me what video it is that, you know, that's on the video, you know, what my references are, please forgive me. There's just no way I can know, because when you get taken down, all the links, you know, your links are taken down as well. So, and because it's so, they're so old, you know, 5 or 6 years, there's just no way of me knowing. And the way things are anyway, you know, they're probably not still up anyway. But this one here, I was really amazed, because here it is. I just sort of get
so by the desires of a very small group.
I'll just show you where it is. And this was here, this, there it is. And now this is the red dragon.
As mystery object enters our solar system.
Okay, so that's on AMTV, so that's a Christopher Green, isn't it?
I'm just going to show you the pictures that prove that what I filmed was the red dragon, and what scientists are now saying. They just don't know. It says, scientists baffled as mystery object enters our solar system. So I just want you to look at that object there, and even though the picture that I caught of the dragon was one from the Earth, so it looks different, but you can see...
Here. Okay, so here it is there. You know, this is the tail of the dragon. You can see there's two cuts, one here and one up the top there. Okay, and so I'll just quickly take you through to my red dragon for those of you who haven't seen it. So I've called it Revelation 13, Red Dragon Cast Out of Heaven. You know, the reason I want to do this, of course, is because I just, so if you go into my content, if you go into my channel, okay, where is he? Okay, there it is there, 1:35. So can you see it there? There is the thumbnail of it. And sometimes you can just see the thumbnail better. So you can see that there's a smaller cut there. Oh, God, I'm doing it again. Sorry, guys. Okay, onto the table. Where am I? It's just so hard to get it on, find it on the blooming table here. Here it is. Okay, there we are. So here you've got this cut here, and this is where the red ball is in there, and there's this cut there, okay, out there, and here's the tail, okay? So here's their rendition of it down below, okay? So you can see... Yeah, the red ball and the cuts. So I'll just play that one for you quickly up there. And okay, so there's the bigger version of it.
Wow, came out to film something else, and I see this. Insane.
Okay, so you can see there's the balls there, this small cut this side, big cut this side, and in the one that I saw, Cookie Monster, you can actually see that NASA saw this thing. I wonder if I can find that. And they called it the Cookie Monster themselves, because in theirs it was actually two objects, and that is what it causes the cut. Two objects like side by side.
A cut out of it. Look, it's a...
Try it, I'll just slow it down.
Oh my goodness, isn't that beautiful? Okay, so I'm looking... I'm looking...
So, okay, I won't, you can go and have a look that up. You know, and the reason I'm doing this is I just really want to, and that was 27th of the 7th, 1917, that I filmed that 1 month after I had my first death and resurrection experience. And I'm going to tell you about that. Some of you don't know what happened then. That was on the solstice. So that was over 2 days, 21st and 22nd of June. And in it, I've done a few videos of it, one with my husband witnessing and, you know, to say that it's really happened. It's quite personal and, you know, nobody would say this unless it was true. But I believe it's important. And, on the first day I got up to make a cup of milk. When I can't sleep, I go and make milk. And but I don't recall doing that. All I remember is that I had obviously gone to do that, and I was now sitting in the on the floor in a puddle of urine, just sort of not knowing how I got there. And, I went and I saw that I must have done that. I must have actually been, making myself a drink of milk, but I hadn't actually turned on the stove. I had put the pot there, I believe, but I hadn't turned it on. So from that moment, so something was obviously had happened then to make me turn around from, turning on the stove, turning on the gas, and then going back through the door. But I don't remember any of that. I don't remember walking to the kitchen. All I remember is walking up, and sitting in a puddle of urine. So I went to my husband and woke him and said something's happened and told him what had happened. And so he actually, went and sort of cleaned up for me. Okay, I'm going to really gross you out now, okay? So I went back to bed, slept. And woke up, everything seemed fine. And then I was sitting at the table. So I must have been sending it, sending it with him? I can't quite remember. Because I was taking some stuff into the food bank and I was sort of labelling it. Little bags, making these little bags up. But I was still in my pyjamas and I was at the table, right, in my pyjamas. And doing these bags, putting words on them of bread that I had made, and then I pooped myself. Didn't remember. How when you go to the toilet, you can feel yourself doing it, but in mine I couldn't feel anything. All I knew was, oh yuck, how did that happen? Where was my husband then? I think I must have rung him then and told him. But over the next 2 days, so that day, I think I would just try and rest, because, of course, I have had that other death experience back in 2008, which I totally believe was connected with Obama. And I think I talk about that in the last video that I have put up. An old one, talk about the incredible dream that I had back in 2008 when Obama, I didn't know anything about him, but I saw his story in the Time magazine, and as I said, I could care less who the American president was, but I had this amazing dream showing everything about him, his homosexuality, everything that we would never have believed about him, because at that day, that time he was showing himself as this, wonderful Christian guy, married with a couple of kids and all this garbage. So, but everything, it turned out everything in my dream was bang on, right? And my dream also said that he had to keep a low profile. He couldn't afford to get found out. But I know that from that time I had other dreams of him, and I knew that I was coming under spiritual attack. And I think that's what I'm speaking of like being the collective, that as one, as all, we are the church plural, and the difference between Obama when he was in power, I would have all these dreams when he was trying to dance with me, he was trying to marry me, he was trying to do anything to get at me, and I believe that is talking about the church, what he was trying to do to destroy the church. Whereas when Trump came along, I was always his wife or Ivanka's mother, and I just dream after dream after dream, and the Lord prepared me with those dreams early 2016, if not 2015, before he was elected. So I knew the difference, and that Trump was God's man. So, you know, this is the whole, where am I going? This is the whole thing with the, you know, the church and believing, you know, and believing that even when you don't think you're doing anything. Now, I really have come to believe that I'm working while I'm dreaming, you know, that just as that man was talking about how they're trying to get you into this collective way of thinking where you're helpless and you're this and that, and you know, you're all fearful, that is their way of lowering your vibration and your power, you know, and you're not doing what God told you you could do, you know, you're not being this. And I also found this week, and this is how the Egyptians, so this was, I think, I can't remember which it was on, but it was a picture of the Egyptians, that they used to be embalmed in baking soda, and they would lie on a couch looking exactly like that, a couch with a lion's head. So that is, you know, the symbolism of resurrection. And I believe, so that's what's happened to me, that, you know, when I went over these 2 days. So one time I was talking to my daughter, I was in my bed, you know, I made sure I sort of rested up. I think I did actually go into town and drop off that stuff, I think. I'll have to go over my notes sometimes, it's such a long time ago now. One time I was sitting in my bed and talking to my daughter on the phone. Her husband walked in, and it was just something he said. He said somebody's name, you know, like something like that, and I was just put into this trance, and I was just a total zombie. But this time, I just started praying in tongues and let my daughter, she didn't know, you know, 1 minute I'm talking to her, and then the next minute I'm praying in tongues. And I just went on and on and on until I finally came out of it, and I could hear her on the phone just calling out to me, you know. And then another time my husband came in, and I would just sort of collapse off the bed, you know. A couple of times I was like this old, I would become this old hag, you know, and he said my face was grey and ashen, and I honestly looked like I was 100 years old. The last one, no, well, not the last one, there was, it went over 2 days, it was pretty horrendous, until finally I thought I better go and I better tell the doctor what happened. And so I went in, and as soon as she heard that I had lost, you know, bodily control a couple of times, she sent me up to the hospital, and I was out in the waiting room. And it was a full house. and to start with, I had my back to everybody. But thankfully, at the end, you know, I as soon as a seat became available across from me, I went and sat in that. And then I had been just reading the Bible. I was fine reading my little Bible. But then I saw an art book on the table, and I reached out and picked up the art book and started reading that. And same thing, it was like a word out the corner of my eye, just as it was at the table. I just saw something written on a book, and that was enough to trigger me and to put me into this trance. And so when that happened, I just sort of started collapsing. So thankfully I was beside people now, and I just sort of put out my hands, and they knew, and they stopped my fall. And then the next thing, next thing I wake up again, and all the, you know, I'm getting put in a wheelchair and shuffled into the room. I jumped the queue, so that was great. So then I was there with an American doctor, Dr. Paul, and he was, you know, asking me questions and everything, and I, several times, you know, I'd have these memories coming back, and I told Dennis to write them down, I won't go into those, but at the end of it, one was the word Bollinger, and that was the guy who wrote the witness of the stars, which I may show you of, you know, that shows, talks about the witness of the stars. So this guy's in the 1800s, and he's the son of a Swiss reformer. So he's a very important Christian back in the day, and wrote also one on the power of numbers, numerology. But the one thing that when I was looking up to find out what the significance of this name Bollinger was, because it's a very unusual name, came across the quote of his son, I think, or grandson, which was, never forget how much, never forget that what you think you know was taught to you by other men. And there's a couple of ways of interpreting that, you know, but also some of the words that I had there was dov, honey, yes, that's right, you bastard, slip and fall, you know, because that was something that happened to me in Cambridge. You know, I didn't slip and fall. It was like there was something really bad downstairs. And there was one time when I fell, I was sort of on a couch trying to take a photo, and it was as if something grabbed hold of my leg and just dropped me. And I, you know, I fell down, and my husband came running from the other side of the room. This table, this really square wooden table, hit my eye. My glasses went flying, you know. And my husband thought, you know, he expected blood to be everywhere, and that I wouldn't make it. He just, you know, and but it was amazing. It was just something just cushioned that fall, and the only thing, I nearly broke my kneecap. But apart from this, my face, everything was fine. So I really knew, you know, that I was under super spiritual attack from when Obama came in. But now, you know, we're not, you know, and now, you know, this. So that is what Anon means, you know, and Jesus said, he's coming back on the clouds. That's what we're meant to be looking for. These are the signs that we're meant to be looking for, you know. And as I've shown you, you know, it's the proverb says, you know, to the glory of God to conceal a thing, and the honor of kings to search it out. So all the things that we've been taught, you know, that occult things hidden, all the things that I had to give up, you know, I didn't have to give up at all, that they were all part of God's incredible design, you know, numerology, you know now, the numbers, God's incredible numbers, you know, but these are all things that the church has taught us to be afraid of. And this is what happened, I believe, with Scotty, and I'm just going to show you, because at this stage here, so there's a part here, I think at 33 minutes, where Sasha Stone really just nails it. You know, because
the whole thing, evolution, is all about the soul journey. It's all about your return to God, door to the source, to light, to prime creator, to Allah, whatever you want to call it. To me, it's the mother father,
and this is what has been taken from us. We've been taken, you know, the whole thing, idea of evolution, not evolution, reincarnation, has been banned also by the church, you know, because, you know, but Jesus, what did he say about John the Baptist? He said, he's already here. Jesus clearly taught reincarnation. You know, when he went up to the mountain, who was there? You know, Moses, you know, Elijah, he talking about it, you know, that was what we are. But the cabal doesn't want us to know that, doesn't want us to know that we have to get to the state where we are going back to the source, we're going back to God, and that we are the source. And that's what I knew when I realized it this week, the whole Muldoon thing, that here, the source, God the Father, God the Mother, you know, God the Holy Spirit, God the Creator, God, you know, who is in us, as Jesus said, that we are one with him, you know, that he was bringing out this man from his death, his grave, the memory of him and what he did to give me a message now, to make me know that him, you know, that man who died all those years ago, and me and you, all of us, we are all just one speck of this incredible circle that just keeps going. And that's what she's talking about in here, right? But at the end of this video, I saw the list, you know, I saw the playlist, and I won't tell you his name out loud, but I'll write it down. You will know who he is by now, you know, because of course he's the main player. And when old what's the name Scotty couldn't say, you know, he was obviously still in shock how he had been, you know, he had kicked off. And also Charlie Ward also was another one. He couldn't understand why. And of course, you know, but when I looked at the list there, you know, I saw this name and I thought, of course you got kicked off. He hates them.
God. It's the absolute...
I mean, have you seen any what he said about this? I mean, this is the whole thing of the whole January, I probably won't say the number, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the next number, you know, blaming this. It was all about this. So it's the same thing about Martin Geddes, you know. These are all because believing that this incredible power has come down, that we are at the end of the tribulations, and this is what, you know, like this end sign, okay? So that's what I'm trying to say to you, that if that was the Revelation Red Dragon, that I know it was, and I've just shown you this other picture, then the next thing is getting on that ship, and I will show you the, I'll just look up the Bollinger now. Okay, so Bollinger, E.W. Bollinger, and I'll show you the history of the stars because I didn't do a very good job of it last time. But you know the boat I'm talking about, don't you? So here he is. Don't let me... So here he is there. Swiss reformer. Okay, you can look him up. What is it called? Witness of the Stars, it's called. Witness of the Stars, E.W. Companion, he did a lot of stuff, he's pretty... have a look. Witness of the Stars. And there you will see the ship Argo, and the ship Argo you never know which one you get getting when you open up the represents it's in the heavens, so this is the whole astrology thing. The return represents the golden fleece, it represents Zion, it represents no, it's a book, but hang on. Chart, e.g., hang on. The pilgrim's return, that's what, you know. So, you know, this is what I want you to understand, that what they're doing, everything there that they're doing to demoralize you, to, you know, to take away your power, your strength, you know, is to lower your vibration and to not be afraid of these people like Scott Mackay, and, you know, talking about things that are outside the Christian way. You know, it's only through that church, you know, that religiosity that has kept you powerless, you know, because you are, you know, your way is different to my way, but, you know, your way is just as powerful the minute that you really believe it is, you know. And, you know, I wish I could tell you the story that I had, you know, when I first went in the church and terrible things happened, as they always do, to really bring me down. And, you know, and I started crying again. And, but I had one good friend start called Stan Shaw. And he talked to me on the phone and he said to me, you know, Christine, when did God ever promise you bad things? And he said, and you know, I had my baptismal prophecy, and I read it through, and I just went through and ticked all the things that were wonderful, and there was no bad things, and that just gave me enough to honestly, you know, just to believe again. And so, you know, I just had it, he just increase my faith. And I thought, no, he never promised me bad things. These are all good things. And that was enough, you know, just to break through all the terrible things that the people in the church had done to me, to take away that power that I had and to put me back in this believing mode. And if I could tell you the things that happened then, you know, that was when I got my first house. And I was the same as I had been initially, just going around, touch me, I'm gold. You know, I would just, people would just do anything for me, you know, because I was exerting this energy. And when you exert that energy of positivity, other people feel it and they're drawn to it, you know. But if you exhibit the other one, you know, you're going to drag them down as well as drag yourself down. And I really cannot believe that I can't find this blooming book. These are all just anything but what I've seen. Hey, it's like, oh my goodness. Maybe if I open it, it will do it. So I'm going to show you the boat. Is there anything else I'm going to do? Oh, so anyway, what happened after I had my star chart done, and the woman said to me, because, you know, it always comes up my father. You know, my father was killed when I was 2.5. And so whenever I talk about that, naturally, you know, I start crying because there's all these other memories that come with it as well. And so this woman, she was American too, and she said, you know, oh, that I have to have this therapy, that there's a new therapy out called EMDR. So it's movement. It's to do with, you know, they bring out these memories. Apparently it is absolutely excellent. And, you know, they just get you to look sideways like this while you're having one of those bad memories. And by doing that, they can reprogram you. Well, my daughter's, you know, she's been doing all this sort of stuff, just been to the pyramids and everything like that. And so she really, you know, was sort of getting on to me and saying, Mum, you've got to do this, you've got to do this. So I actually rang up, you know, a counsellor who does it. And I sort of wrote it down, you know, all the garbage I've been through and everything. And then straight away, I just started not feeling right about it. And I was out in my queen house, and which I go where I go every night, you know, to watch the sunset. And afterwards, you know, I saw in the sky, you know, the same eyes that I painted in that painting over there. You don't need to see it. And I could just sort of feel as if God was saying, what are you doing? You know, why do you need anyone else again? And then, but on top of that, you know, I thought, oh, am I just trying to get out of it? Because, you know, I hate crying. You know, it absolutely wipes me. And I just don't do it. I'm just so happy these days. Why would I want to remember anything that makes me unhappy? And but lo and behold, you know, so my daughter went down to Wellington and she saw where we used to live, Paraparam. She saw this big sign saying EMDR therapy. And so she says, oh, wow, see, look, that was the first thing I saw. You know, you must have to do it and da-da-da-da. So that's why, you know, I contacted this therapist. But then on the same day, what should be in my letterbox? But this letter. A handwritten letter from someone called Antoinette, and it says here, Dearest neighbour, I am writing to you today to share a unique Bible message. Today it seems as if the world's conditions are only getting worse. Without a doubt, we are living in critical times, hard to deal with, that are causing many forms of distress. Mental health has been a staggering high, with ages from as young as 5 years old to 85 years. Mental disorder is not the result of personal weakness. It's a medical condition that causes significant distress and disrupts a person's thinking, emotional control, and behavior. Psalm 34:18, Jehovah is close to the brokenhearted. He saves those who are crushed in spirit. He wants to do as Isaiah 41:13 says, I, Jehovah, your God, am grasping your right hand, the one saying to you, do not be afraid, I will help you. So it just goes on, and that, and I thought, oh gosh. So she's a Jehovah's Witness. I couldn't believe it. And so that was my sign. So I wrote to the counselor. I said, like, no, I won't be needing you. And so I'll just get back to this here and let you finish off on that. You know, the dreams that I had, you know, this was another thing that this guy, Don McLean, you know, Vincent, you know, and he had mental problems, of course. And, you know, but one of the other songs, you know, since I played Vincent has been really coming to me, and which was Bye Bye Miss American Pie, which I never could understand before, but I really just understood the power of music and why is it that they said that Satan, you know, that he was the one that makes music up in heaven, you know. And I came across this other dream that I just had a couple of days ago, because during the time when I was thinking of going to see this psychiatrist or whatever, counsellor, another song from somebody called Peter Sarsted, you probably haven't heard of him, he was an Australian, and he was like about a three-hit wonder. One of his hits was Where Do You Go To, My Lovely, When You're Alone in Your Bed, you'll know that one maybe. But another one that he had, there was two, you know, but the one that I kept thinking of today, this week, was, what was it? It was, oh gosh, now I can't remember it, can I? It was about keeping, I've got to learn, these are the words, I've got to learn to stay within myself, let no man take me for another, and if I stay within myself, I will be blessed, okay? And it wasn't a great tune, that one, but the words just got there, and I always sort of wondered what that was. And another one that he sang was, I Am a Cathedral. You know, I looked up from my book, and I thought, I am a cathedral in my mind. And the whole thing is about this, I am a cathedral. And I thought, you know, back then, it was a strange song. But now I know, you know, when I think of that dream that I had just, you know, the few years ago when I realised God was judging the church, he was pulling down the steeple, you know, and the steeple was open so that he could look inside and see what was there really, you know, there, what was sitting on the pews. And that is where we're at, you know. And you remember the other, you know, the dream that I had, sort of same thing, which I spoke of recently, where I walked into a church and there were a couple of women in the church, and they, I tried to get them to look up, they wouldn't look up, which has always been the way. I'm always saying, look up, no one does. And I ended up telling them they were full of SHIT. And then when I walked out, I saw this twinkling star. And that's what I always do, you know. It's like I wake up in bed, I see a twinkling star, you know. But I get my camera and have a look because, you know, because I've got faith in God, you know, and I know, you know, that if you expect something to happen, it will happen. You know, it's all about you creating that, you know. And in that dream, you know, I walked out of the church and looked up in the sky and saw this big tiger, you know. And that is talking about, you know, as opposed to this, which is really relying on Christ, the tiger is becoming Christ. The tiger is the real primal force, you know, that when you're in charge, that you're the stealth one, you know, that he is the real king of the forest, you know, some say. And, but, you know, God gives us stuff. You know, he is close to the brokenhearted, and that's why I believe music is so, so powerful and how it lifts our spirits up, you know. But all through the ages, you know, there'll be songs that come, that, you know, these singers talk about, you know, these songs just dropping into their laps. You know, they come from God. God, it's, you know, God just drops it, the whole collective consciousness drops it into their laps, you know, to bless, you know, so many. You know, we all think, oh, that song was made for me, you know. And I always thought that about Leonard Cohen. I could not believe the things that he said, and I just attributed that guy, I give that guy, you know, credit for saving my life. I do not think that I would have survived my teenage and you know, young years if it wasn't for Leonard Cohen, you know, and his incredible words that gave me so much faith. And, you know, that was what I realised when, you know, I thought of American Pie, drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys drinking whiskey and rye, singing, "This will be the day that I die." It was the day the music died, you know, and when the music dies, we all die. Because, you know, God is the song in our heart. And this was the other dream. I just sat down, found on my desk when I sat down to do this video. The composer, my lover, which is God, of course, had written me a song, and I was admiring the words he had carefully chosen. Then he came and held me. He was tall and dark, not someone I knew that I can remember, but I was so enthralled when he held me and swooned when he asked me if I wanted to lay down and make love, all the rest of it. Yes, and of course I did. You know, so, you know, this is how God wants to is to make love to us all the time. And, you know, he will, you know, we all have a different path, a different song. We all have a different song, but just put on that music, lift up your spirits and start believing, and don't let these guys, you know, do what they're trying to do. I'll leave you with
the purest expression of love. And in order to return to that, we have to love ourselves completely. And so, you know, in my travels and in my exposure to higher dimensional beings, who are just, you know, great souls who are a little farther along the path than us and helping and turning back to shine light for us, they have, you know, explained that all of creation is a hierarchy. And it's not a pyramidal hierarchy like human hierarchy structures are. It is it's a circular one, with the closest, the highest vibrations of the angelic realm being closest to God. And it branches out from there, and each one of us is on a different part of our soul evolution, where there are about, I would say, 10 to 11 steps kind of understood by humans to get to the highest level of consciousness of perfected beings that we can be at. And each one of those levels of consciousness,
and this is Sasha Stone,
leaps that you take, unlock different spiritual abilities, and because
Is really about idolatry and how.
Oh, this was really good. And this has a real message to the church. As it is.
From that typhonic state as babes. We are received by elders, by grown ups, by adults, people fully mind fucked and indoctrinated into their Islamism or their fundamentalist baptism, you know, or their whatever their idiom is, the cultural, socio-cultural program gets hold of us as babes, as infants, and begins the inculcation of that particular brand of false light, which is idolatry. And I've said bluntly and boldly for a long time that most good Christians are idolaters, most good Buddhists are idolaters, most good Hindus and Muslims are idolaters, in as much as they are transfixed by the gospel, by the doctrine, by the dogma, and by the conformity, but they are absent in an understanding of the living gospel, of the flame of the Christ consciousness, which is consciousness in action. So for me, the conversation, which was beautifully elucidated by Megan and Matthias and Mark, is really about idolatry and how do we begin the process of disentangling ourselves from idolatry in the first instance as a ground zero toward then actualizing in the now, in the perfect geometry of now. And now is always the perfect time, because the perfect geometry of now is where we discover timelessness. Timelessness can only ever be found when we are fully actualized in the living moment. And so that then becomes for me.
And what does Jesus say about that? Doesn't he tell us to live in the now? You know, that and just know, just like the birds, that you'll be provided for. Just no worries, no past, no future, but now. So I'll leave it at that. I'm sure it's a lot longer than I hoped, and I hope I haven't frightened any of you. Well, I don't care, really. I need a lot of, I know, you know, it's hard to get to the place, you know, that we need to be to not come back. You know, these dark powers want us coming back. They want us stuck on earth so that we never are back in the spirit with God. We're never perfected, you know, because as long as they can keep us down in depression, keep us down hating ourselves, you know, we never experience this resurrection. We never are elevated and are spirit again, true spirit. You know, we're always in the flesh, always, you know, worried about, you know, where we're going to get our next meal from, you know, why that person doesn't like us, you know, what did we do wrong? You know, it's not until you really learn to love yourself and to know you are the utter perfection of God Almighty that you can walk, you know, with all your four baubles. You know, we've all got them, you know, we're all totally imperfect people, but as long as, you know, we just realize God doesn't make mistakes, I'm great. And so are you, you know, and I just pray that I will leave that with you today, that you will, you know, wake up tomorrow, you know, feeling better than you did today, because great things are happening. I know that. And just from that revelation, Red Dragon, and I didn't quite get to show you the Argo, but maybe I'll just Argo, see if I can get it. You know, you've seen the boats that I've shown you. You know, you can go and have a look at all my signs and know that that was Revelation 13, Red Dragon. So, and we've had all these other signs here. And Joel, it says the sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the great coming of the Lord. You know, because these people don't want you to know what's around the corner. And this it coincides with the eclipse. So after I had that death experience, then the next month I filmed the dragon cast out of heaven. The next month you had the great USA eclipse. And you know when that crosses over again? Was it April 24, you know? So guess what? And we also have, there's another one. There's a solar eclipse on October the 14th. That's the day after the day of our elections this year in New Zealand, you know, which was totally connected with what you guys are going on last time, but I won't go there. That was we were connected to the Virgin sign, you know, but we have that eclipse then. So that will be October 14th, just before your election, you know. So you have a look, go and look it up, the solar eclipse, and that crossover goes over the USA again. And boy, you know, because if it doesn't happen, we're dead schmuck, you know, as you know. And but I believe, I really believe what happened to Martin, you know, that his Twitter has been put back on, and that these guys are in charge. And the minute that you really believe that and start walking out in your power, nothing, you know, nothing can stop us. But we've got to do it in a collective. We are all one. We are all God. And you can't, you know, stop being afraid of that crazy talk. So I bless you all in Jesus' name, and hope you're having a lovely day. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you again later. Bye-bye.